course, the video never shows it, but you can watch all of the cells in this gold owl not just rolling nice and gently. As long as the cells are rolling and active, they clean up really well. This stuff works really good for catching our flower gold up here. I've been using this now for two years. I've tried Dream Mat. It was a horrible disappointment up here. Like, I tried it and tried it and tried it, and it just would not. You get more coming out the end of your box than you actually caught in the mat. It doesn't matter how you adjust the angle or the flow. That's all bullshit. Three different profiles of gold owl in this box. The one I'm using it as a 36. I can put my extension on and I can add another 3 feet worth of mat. But when I'm running it like this, I've got a more aggressive profile of the gold owl mat for my two first mats. So the one under the dampener and this first one here. And I've got their small ripple profile here. I use this one mostly just as a tell to see what is actually being caught up in the bigger ripples and a little bit down below. So this is the deeper well profile. I've got three pieces of it in here. Most of what I collect when I'm running this setup, stop right here. The last two maps there, you don't usually find much in them at all. But I've also got Miner's Moss and Deep V up in my hash box. Just because it was getting the crap beat out of it through the boulders all the time. So no matter what you run, doesn't matter if it's Dream Mat or Gold Owl or anything, any kind of matter, always run it down for a minute. It's a hard lesson for new guys. And you can show them the difference before and after. I can run this with the damper lifted up. And afterwards, found the tailings, and you'll find quite a bit of gold. With that damper in there, yeah, it does wonders. I should probably actually make it a little bit longer, maybe about another 10 inches. That flower gold can be tricky to catch sometimes. That's our first trip out this year. July the 18th from the Big Smokey River, just out outside of Grande Prairie. Well, it's kind of between Grande Prairie and DeHolt, but this whole area was under about an extra 8 feet of water, 10 feet of water not long ago. It's all flooded out. It's been raining all spring, the first time I've been able to actually get out and got a new drone to play with. We got the new Tacoma. Even with everything going on in the world right now, it's still pretty good here for me. It's not surprising. This is all gonna no doubt crash and burn soon. Anyways, there's my setup. If you watch my other videos, you can see how it all works. And it works damn good. I'll do a bit more shoveling here, go home, do it for now. We've only moved about maybe a quarter, maybe a third of the yard. So that's about enough for me today. be amazed how much stuff you catch in a crash box, Matt. Downright amazed. Lots of dust in there. And at the end of the day, we go home with about half an inch of cons in the bottom of that gold pen. And I'll run it through my deep V sluice at home, clean it up some more, and then throw it on the Miller table. I probably got 0.05 of a gram for moving as much dirt as I did. So, we'll see. We're all packed up now, ready to go. I'm not quite ready to go. It's a matter of etiquette, and not enough people really care about it, but whatever. Please don't leave your tailings piles mounded up like that. After a while, it starts to really look like crap. So if you're gonna dig somewhere, you fill your holes back in, just like golfing. Okay, get that straight.
It's like magic, you'd hardly know I was here.
This is actually a nice little spot. Runoff from the bankers. Goes right down there. Nice little settling pond. It's actually pretty good because there's a bunch of people using green mat and you have a location like this, you can just sluice their tailings. They get like 10 times more than they ever did. Alright, time to go home. Damn, I need a jet boat. Quite a bit of destruction in here. Not high water. It's actually dirt on all those plants about 2 feet up. So she flooded really good through here. And if you know Moody's Crossing in the campground, they got that all shut down right now. Got some cleanup to do. So that happens when you build stuff on an old floodplain. Boy, do they ever blend in well. He's still standing right there. That'll be a nice buck in the fall if anybody gets him.